Dear students, I am going to start the second module. Second module is about the, here three chapters you have to study. One is the file attributes and permission. Second chapter is the shell interpretive cycle. And third chapter is shell program. So, here we will start with the first chapter, which is the file attributes and permission. File ownership, actually in Unix, it is a set of, Unix is a set of files. So every file has some attributes. Every file has some attributes, I mean characteristics. And who all can access those files, that permission, that is called the permission. So file has the attributes, characteristics, properties, and the one who very limited people have the permission to access those files. So file ownership is an important component of Unix that provides a secure method for storing files. Every file in Unix has the following attributes. First, ownership, owner permission. Owner permission is nothing but the owner's permission determines what action the owner of the file can perform on the file. I mean, suppose if I create a file, then I will be the owner of the file. Then what all permissions I have on that file, whether write, read and execute. There are three kinds of permissions will be given. So the owner permission determines what action a owner can take place on the file. Next one is the group permission. The group's permission determines what actions a user who is a member of the group that a file belongs to can perform on the file. See, every user belongs to a group. So, if owner of a file has created a file, then that owner belongs to some group. Other member of the group, what all actions they can have, what all the actions they can take place on the file, that is called the group permission. Then other or world permission. The permissions for others indicate what action all other users can perform apart from owner of the file and group owner of the file. What other people can do the action on the file, that is called the other permission. Here the action is nothing but read permission, write permission or execute permission. So in shortcut, if I say every file has three owners, owner, group and other. And they have different three permissions, read permission, write permission and execute permission. So owner have a different permission, read, write, execute. Group has this different permission, read, write and execute, and others also have the different permission, read, write or execute. It depends. Next one, which we are going to talk about the file attributes in detail. So there are seven file attributes every file has. Whenever a file is created in Unix operating system, so seven attributes will be associated with that file. And those seven attributes of a file we can display using the command ls-l command. So what are the seven attributes the file has? First is file type and permission. Second one is link. Third is ownership. Fourth one is group ownership. Fifth one, file size. Sixth one is last modification date and time. And seventh one is file name. So these seven attributes, what else are the things? Let us study in little detail. The first one is file type. The file type and its permissions are associated with each file. Your file type is nothing but whether it is a regular file, text file or directory. And permissions are nothing but read permission, write permission or execute permission. Then links indicate the number of file name as is maintained by the system. See, every file, one file can have different names, which will be maintained by the Unix operating system. So links indicate for the same file how many different names are there in the Unix operating system. So that is nothing but link. File is created by owner. Third attribute is the owner. The owner who has created the file. Fourth one, every user is attached to a group. Group owner. Every user belongs to a group. Next one, file size in bytes is displayed. Yes. Size of the file is displayed. Then last modification time is the next field. When was the last time file was accessed and it was modified? Whether the contents are deleted or appended, all these things. So that is called last modification time. Next, if you change only the permissions or ownership of the file, the modification time remains unchanged. Here, modification of the file means if you have deleted some content in the file, then the last modification time will be changed. If you have added something in the file, then also the last modification time of the file is changed. But if you have only changed the ownership of file or permission of the file, then the last modification time of the file will not be changed. In the last field, it displays the file name. Okay, so these are the seven attributes will be there. Once again, I can repeat it. First one is file type and permissions associated with file. Second one, links of the file. Third one, owner of the file. Fourth one, group owner of the file. Fifth one, file size. Sixth one, last modification time. And seventh one is file name. So these are the seven attributes will be associated with every file. Let us see, as I said that using ls-l command, we can display all the seven attributes of a file. So I have typed a command ls-l and here total 72 files are present in my current directory. So I can see here first few files attributes. So here dash is there. Means dash is there, it means it is a regular file. But for last two files, you can see D means these two are directory files. Next one is read, write and hyphen is there. Means this file, owner has only read and write permission. It doesn't have the execute permission. Next three